Well, as we mentioned earlier, one of the greatest two-year-olds in pacing history not here. That's Jake Lobell, but one of the great ones is here, and Alan Kirshenbaum takes a look at these two stars.
There's a chance that 1986 may best be remembered as the year that Jake Lobell first set foot on the racetrack. As spectacular a freshman as has ever been seen, this performance, just 1/5 of a second off Nihilator's world record on a surface much less than fast, has to be considered one of the most impressive efforts ever recorded. He is the strong favorite for divisional honors and a very legitimate Horse of the Year candidate. In his absence, the Redskin has taken the scalps from his competition. And in recent weeks, including this courageous score in the Governor's Cup here at Garden State Park, he has become a legitimate threat to Jake Lobell's divisional hopes. He has danced every dance, fought every fight, and has socked away well over $1 million in the process. I spoke with Redskins owner and trainer, Jerry Smith, last night, and he believes his protege has proven himself on the field of battle.
With a win in the Breeders' Crown, do you think that Redskin deserves to be voted two-year-old Colt Pacing Colt of the Year?
Well, I'm not sure I understand how they vote. You know, there's Redskin obviously has made the most money. If he does a little good tomorrow night, he'll be the high money winner of any two-year-old ever, which I think certainly deserves a lot of credit. Another Colt has got a faster record than Redskin or Jake Lobell. So I'm not sure what they're looking for. A Colt has raced against all of the Colts all year and made the most money, I think certainly deserves some consideration.
Would you vote for him?
Yes, I certainly would.
Now, what about Redskin's chances in the Breeders' Crown? How's he coming up to the race?
Well, he's trained perfect. You know, it's like I say, he started in May, and he's raced tough right through. These Colts has got to start getting tired pretty quick. That's a long season for a two-year-old. This is pretty late to be racing two-year-old. Latest I've ever raced a Colt. So you never know when they're going to start tailing off a little bit. But he certainly looks like he's come into this race in good shape.
He seems to like the track here at Garden State, too.
Yeah, he's handled his track pretty well.
And Redskin is warming up right now for the fifth race. The two-year-old Colts and Geldings will be on the pace for this mile event in the Breeders' Crown after we take this brief timeout.